Good afternoon. This is Dr. Girija Wagh. I am an MD OBGYN specializing in obstetric care, high-risk obstetrics, infertility, pregnancy planning, and so many other issues related to women's reproductive health. I am in practice for the past 29 years, and I consult at the Cloudnine Shivaji Nagar and a professor at Bharati Hospital in Pune. I'm here to answer your questions today for pregnancy planning, that is preconceptional care, and antenatal care and management. So good afternoon, everybody. Your fibers are falling in this view. We all know that pregnancy has to be planned properly because many a times women usually get to visit a doctor only when they become pregnant or they're desiring pregnancy. And in the today's changing world, we see that there are many issues that women still want to be answered. Yes, here's Vidyashree, and she has asked me, I had a 1 year, 4 year old son and I need another one baby, but the pregnancy does not stop him. Please suggest me. I had 1 4-year-old baby. Huh? So she is probably not getting pregnant and that's her concern. She already has a 4 year old son. Vidya, you require to come for checkup because we need to find out 2-3 things. Whether you are getting your periods on time, have you put on a lot of weight, whether there are any issues like hypothyroidism or increased insulin resistance. And this will help us in identifying what is the reason that you are not getting pregnant. If a woman is desiring to get pregnant and tries for the period of 1.5 years and is not able to conceive, she requires to be checked. So I would request you to get yourself checked up. Raju Vadageri has asked for pregnancy suggestion. I do not understand this question, Raju. Can you just again put it in a little more perspective? Kartika has endometriosis on left ovary and wants to know whether this can be a barrier to get pregnant. Yes, Kartika, it can be a barrier to pregnancy because as you understand, endometrioma is a swelling which is present inside the ovary and it can sometimes compromise the function of the ovary of producing eggs. So it is essential that you find out whether there you have adequate ovarian reserve or not. And it's important that you get checked up and do not delay getting pregnant. Praveen Tripathi wants to know whether antenatal care, what is it? Antenatal care is a care which is given to a pregnant mother. During the pregnancy, from the time of diagnosing the pregnancy, from assessing her any risk factors, trying to find out whether there are any upcoming problems which are going to be there in the pregnancy, to planning pregnancy to ensure that there is a healthy baby born of a healthy mother is what antenatal care entails all about. Now, Ibags want to know, pregnancy mein neend jyada aa rahi aur thakan ka pura ehsaas, please help. Now, we have to understand that getting feeling sleepy is one of the signs of pregnancy and it is mentioned in all our scriptures that it is okay to sleep during pregnancy because that is going to help you to rest. But sometimes some medications may make you sleepy and sometimes it is possible, sometimes it is possible that you are really, really tired. Please find out whether you are suffering from any anemia, whether there is any disease, what is the reason of your sleeping. And you have to understand that pregnancy is a very normal physiological function of your body. And therefore, you should not feel tired. If you are feeling tired, look for anemia, hypothyroidism. See whether you are taking the correct diet because you require a proper nutritional guidance during pregnancy. So that is extremely important. Now, Preeti wants to know how to get a pregnancy. Wonderful question, Preeti. Actually, I think you require to have a session with us for helping you to counsel you as to how do we get pregnant. You have to remember that pregnancy is as a result of a healthy sexual activity. And this healthy sexual activity has to be between two healthy people. And that will help you in getting pregnant. Nowadays, there is a lot of practice amongst women to try and see whether, try to time their pregnancies and time the ovulation. It is not so. It's just that you have to allow it to be in flow, ensure that you are having a regular sexual activity, a normal sexual activity, and that will make you pregnant. Sami wants to know, can I conceive naturally after 4 years of my marriage? Of course, Sami, you can. But it's been 4 years, and if you've not been using any contraceptive and still you've not been able to conceive, then I would suggest that you undergo a preconceptional checking. We need to know whether your body mass index is normal, whether you have anemia, hypothyroidism, whether you have any abnormalities in your ovulation or menstruation, whether you are properly vaccinated, whether your husband is vaccinated and protected against certain infections, especially the rubella and such infections which can be transferred to your baby. Smriti wants to know what to take care while trying to get pregnant. I have thyroid and PCOD and small height and overweight. Smriti, you need to lose your weight. Your ideal body mass index before getting pregnant should be at least 26, max to max 26. Because if you are overweight, that can come in the way of your ovulation, and that can cause problems not only in conception, it can be responsible for very early miscarriages. And it is also important that you start taking certain supplements before you conceive, such as the folic acid. And if you have PCOD, we need to find out whether you have any kind of ovulation, sort of insulin resistance, which may make you diabetic during pregnancy. Deepika wants to know that, doctor, when should we start pre-pregnancy planning? The moment it comes to your mind that you want to have babies, and in fact, I suggest that before, even if you get married, before you get into intimacy, it is important that you have one visit to the doctor to guide you to, to identify what are the various things that you require to look into to get pregnancy. So I hope, Deepika, this answers your question. Okay, Smita, Smriti, you told me to talk a little louder. I hope you got all my answers. If you have not, please pose a question again. Now, Pooja wants to know that her first baby is premature. What should I do in the next pregnancy? Absolutely. You need to find out first why you are, you had that preterm baby. Now, preterm baby can be a multifactorial problem. So it can be a multifactorial issue wherein it can be an infection, it can be a structural abnormality, there can be some medical disorder, there can be something as simple as anemia. So you require to find out whether any of these things are there, and if you are able to come for pre-pregnancy planning, that will definitely help you in trying to find out what can be prevented this time to prevent a preterm delivery. So these are I can't go beyond this question, so can you just help me here? Yeah. It's going up. Now, Sami, I have finished. Screen name. Go up on this. Now, Pooja wants to know that I have answered. Pooja, I hope I have answered your question. Now, Niharika wants to know how to prepare your body before pregnancy. As I have been just mentioning, please see that your body mass index is 26. Start less than 26 folic acid supplementations. It also has to be more than 19. Ensure that you're not taking any medications. If you're on any medications like antihypertensive or any anti-diabetic medicines or any anti-epileptic or tubercular medicines, please ensure that you are off them or you have modulated them before you plan your babies. Ensure that you are in a regular exercise pattern, that you have corrected your diets, you are going to be able to take an adequate rest, and then venture. And please don't forget to immunize and vaccinate yourself against certain transferable infections to your baby. Vaishali wants to know that she has missed abortion 4 months back due to baby was not developed and no heartbeat. So why did this happen and what should I do for planning? Vaishali, you need to find out why did you have this missed abortion. Now, very early missed abortions can be just because that there was some congenital abnormality or karyotypical abnormality in the baby, and the nature decided that this baby should not continue. But then there are certain other correctable disorders like hypothyroidism, diabetes, anemia, which can also be responsible for missed abortions, and this can be corrected. And if you do a proper planning, we can definitely overcome this particular problem. Geetika Mehra wants to know, does antenatal exercises really help in maintaining weight post-pregnancy? Absolutely. It is extremely important that a woman has a proper antenatal exercise. The reason is that you have to maintain a proper body circulation. You have to maintain a proper fat content of your body. You should have proper appetites to take good food. Your body remains mobile. That will also ensure, therefore, that the blood circulation will flow properly. And this all will ensure to not only keep your weight low, but it will prevent a lot of preventable disorders make your body agile, and it will also prevent from you developing post-pregnancy excessive weight. Sahara wants to know what dietary lifestyle changes are required before planning a baby. Sahara, you have to look at the three important components of the diet. One is the carbs. Your carbohydrate source has to be from complex carbohydrates. You have to be just off all that fast food and bakery products which have nothing but only calories. You have to also ensure that you are taking a lot of proteins in your diet. Protein should be to the tune of 1 gram per kg body weight on a daily basis. These have to be healthy proteins. You have to ensure that you are taking fibers to the tune of 200 to 300 grams per day. And you have to take a lot of fresh fruits, vegetables, micronutrients, which will help you in giving good amount of folic acid, folates and B12, which can help you in preventing unnecessary complications in your pregnancy. And you have to also ensure that you are having a regular physical activity. Now, MD Arif wants to know about pre-pregnancy counseling tips. I have mentioned quite a few, but I would like to make a little difference for you, Arif. It is also important to have the right attitude. You have to have a very positive mental attitude. You have to be peaceful. You have to be happy. You have to be content. And don't get unnecessarily wired up, because that will help you in planning your pregnancy and avoiding complications in a better way. Now, Piyush, I have just now spoken to you about nutrition pre-pregnancy. And the same thing is important, that you take a lot of fibers, proteins, as much as I told you, 1 gram per kg body weight. And every day you must ensure that you are having clean bowels, a lot of urine that you can pass. Never forget to drink at least 4 to 5 liters of water per day. Geetika wants to know whether breathing exercise help during normal delivery. Is pain reduced to a certain limit? Absolutely. Deep breathing exercises have to be a part of your regular existence, more so during your antenatal period. Deep breathing helps in proper oxygenation of all your tissues, the placenta, and consequently the baby. It also helps in improving your lung compliance. So when you are in pain during labor, you have the strength to push, and during that strength, when you decide to hold your breath, the baby remains properly oxygenated. So it's extremely important that you have breathing exercises. Pain alleviation during labor requires a lot of mind modulation. You have to have a little dissociated attitude, a happy attitude. Always look at the positive outcome that is going to be there, and that's going to help you. Sarah wants to know whether a diabetic woman can plan a baby. Absolutely, Sarah. A diabetic mother can be pregnant. You have to just ensure whatever I've just now mentioned about pre-pregnancy care. Ensure that your HbA1c, that is glycosylated hemoglobin level, is well controlled. It is always a good practice to have it lower than 5.7. Change your anti-diabetic medicines if they are the ones which are, there are few medicines which are not to be taken during the first trimester. You can shift to either metformin or maybe insulin, which would be safe. And then ensure that you do not have any other underlying cardiac disorder or any eye issues. And then, of course, you can go ahead and plan pregnancies. Is there any specific age difference that we should keep between two children? Actually, there is nothing specific about it, but it's logical to keep at least a gap of 2.5 years between two children. For the simple reason that your first baby is still growing up, it requires your attention and it requires a mental psychological security to know that you are caring for it enough before the other one comes. Also, that interval of 2.5 years time gives you some time to take rest for your body to come back, recover from the first birth. And this way, it's always better to have an optimal distance between both the children. Also, Deepika wants to know what could be the right biological age to go ahead with pregnancy. I see a lot of women delaying it to late 30s and early 40s. If you ask me the truth, the actual right biological age is between 25 to 32. 25 because you are now mature enough to take on the responsibility of the pregnancy and the family. And 32 because after that, the ovarian aging, bodily aging starts happening. So maybe your fertility potential, the capacity of producing eggs may reduce. So it's always better to ensure that you become pregnant between 25 to 32. But many a times today, late marriages occur. Doesn't matter, even if you decide to marry late, it is imperative that you consult a doctor immediately, a gynecologist, who can correct your metabolic parameters and guide you about pregnancy. Sarah again wants to know, women with high blood pressure have issues conceiving. Yes, they may have issues getting pregnant, and they may also have issues like pregnancy-related hypertension complicating that pregnancy. But then this can be tackled, because if you decide to take proper care before conception, at least 3 months, we give you correct dietary corrections, control your blood pressure. Continuous monitoring during pregnancy definitely helps in giving us proper outcomes. So you should not have this fear about getting pregnancy. What complications are faced in late pregnancies, especially after 30s? One of the important things that can happen is women, when they cross the age of 32, have a higher incidence of miscarriages. They may find it difficult to get pregnant. Secondly, there is higher incidences of preterm deliveries, women becoming hypertensive, that is a raise in blood pressure, or diabetic, or women having higher incidences of malformations in the baby. So malformations or congenital abnormalities like Down syndrome and such kind of things can be more commoner when women cross the age of 30. Now, Deepika wants to know, would you suggest the antenatal session would also be given to mom-in-laws too, as they have different set of principles? Wonderful. We don't mind it. We are absolutely welcome to have your mother-in-law to attend our antenatal sessions, because one companion can definitely attend and we can have such special sessions. We can, if you request, you can send us a request and we can do that. Geetika, how can a working woman who is pregnant can take care of herself? Geetika, a working woman is a very smart woman. As she plans for the place where she's working, she can also plan her life. So if you have a proper planning, and it's always ideal to put it on a piece of paper, what timelines can you spend in exercising, dieting, managing your work, managing your household, looking for assistance. Sometimes you can source food from a healthy source. Such kind of things can be undertaken. And of course, all working women should never allow pregnancy to be a hindrance in their work, nor work as a hindrance in their pregnancy. Jai wants to know, my wife, Jai Prakash Saha, I think this is a man. He wants to know, my wife cannot conceive pregnancy since last years. Jai, you need to get her and yourself a checkup as early as possible. Please do not waste more time, because we need to find out, and there are various ways and means in which we can come across and making your parents. Samrin Kausar wants to know, does decreasing HCG during first trimester risk in pregnancy? My first HCG in 4 weeks was 23, my second is 5, and now it's come down to 14. It means that it is just a chemical pregnancy, which is not going to progress at all. But Samrin, this is just based on your HCG that I am giving this particular conclusion. It's important that your entire clinical context is seen into this to say something. But such a less HCG just means that it is probably a non-significant level, not conducive with pregnancy. Sorin Ton Bara wants to know, what are the food supplements I need to take when trying for pregnancy? Lots of green leafy vegetables, rich in folates. You can take folic acid supplements, you can take DHA, you can take vitamin D in periconceptional period, pyridoxine, and B12 if you are not taking it enough from your diet. Sarah Tejani wants to know, is it compulsory to get your health of your reproductive organs and breast checked before planning? It's always a good practice to have a good checking, because finally, today we have to have planned pregnancies, because we have to ensure that the mother and the baby both are healthy. Apart from age barrier, what can be other hindrances in conceiving? Aging, if you have any vices, if you have any diseases, these can be hindrances in your conception. Sometimes even mental illnesses, too much of anxiety, stress can come in the way of conception and taking this pregnancy ahead. Now, Bhavish wants to know, what is the role of genetic test in pre-pregnancy? Which tests need to be done? Actually, we do not recommend any genetic tests in the pre-pregnancy period unless and until there is some family or genetic disorder which has been well established in a prior pregnancy or inside the family. So if that is so, then we recommend. Like for example, if a couple has had her first baby who is suffering from thalassemia major, or one of the parents is suffering from thalassemia, then that is a hemoglobin disorder which can cause chronic anemia and lot of problems. So in such a situation, you may consider going in for genetic testing beforehand, so that you know that such a disorder would not happen after both you and your wife make a baby. Similarly, there can be a Duchenne's muscular dystrophy, which is known to affect some children, and especially male children when they are born. In such a case, it's always a good practice to undergo this testing before pregnancy. But many a times we embark on pregnancy without knowing what is our genetic milieu. And then there are certain tests which can also be done once you become pregnant. Arya wants to know, I am not able to get pregnant from 2 years. Arya, you need to come for guidance. And you must pay attention to whatever I have said just now. Now, Deepika wants to know, doctor, can migraine medication like Suminate 50 taken during pregnancy have any side effects on the baby? Actually, not really. But what I would suggest, Deepika, there can be so many other wonderful ways of trying to overcome your migraine without medicines. So that is very important. Deepika wants to know, is it possible for a woman to know that she cannot conceive? Yes, there are various ways in finding out. We can do your checkup, we can do your sonography, we can do certain blood tests like the anti-Müllerian hormone test, the FSH, certain hormonal tests. All these tests can show us whether there is a possibility of you getting pregnant or not. Deepika says, doctor, what to do when you get false pregnancy alarm? Nothing to worry. Just get yourself confirmed. Don't get worried, your battery is low. So don't get worried, and you can still continue, positively looking forward to a pregnancy. Can folic acid be started before planning pregnancy also? Of course, Deepika. Folic acid is a good practice. Actually, the recommended dose is something to the tune of 450 micrograms per day. And most of the Indian formulation contains 5 milligrams. It doesn't matter. And you can also ensure that you are taking diet which is rich in folic acids. Now, can we start folic acid before planning pregnancy? Yes, it's a good practice to start folic acid before starting pregnancy. Now, Deepika again is a minor thal trait, but my partner has normal blood group. What are the chances of my baby carrying the same trait? Actually, the chances are very less. But what we can do, Deepika, for you is once you become pregnant, after you cross 12 weeks, we can do what is called as a non-invasive perinatal testing, that is NIPT, with a specific request for finding out whether your baby, which is now conceived, has thalassemia of any kind. And that can help us with a good sensitivity and a specificity. This can be identified beforehand. There are so many other things also which require to be looked into. The current challenge that we have in our preconceptional clinic and antenatal clinics is excessive weight gain and absolute immobility by the mothers. Mothers just do not have any exercise routine. And that is something that we need to establish as a part of our pre-pregnancy counseling. A simple thing like walking 4,000 to 5,000 steps daily, maintaining your weight and maintaining your mental attitude and diet properly would go a long way in ensuring that you are pregnant with a healthy baby. It is also important that you screen yourself for hypothyroidism or diabetes. Sarbani wants to know how to get rid of back and body ache during pregnancy. Sarbani, probably back and body ache usually happens because of three important reasons. One of the reasons of body ache is maybe a wrong posture. The moment a woman becomes pregnant, she becomes a little more conscious. She's worried about losing a pregnancy or something. Makes her body stiff and absolutely does not do any exercise. A good exercise, a light stretch, then walking, goes a long way in reducing your back and body ache. You can do some stretching exercises under exercise guiding person. In addition, it can be a sign of calcium and vitamin D deficiency, which requires to be improvised. Ritu wants to know what all things to avoid before conceiving a pregnancy. Ritu, when you are planning your baby, now you have to remember that conception usually occurs after the 14th of day when the ovulation occurs from the later part of your menstrual cycle. That is from the 14th day to the time that you get your periods is the time when a baby is happening. You must ensure that during this time you do not take any medicines inadvertently. Like any simple thing like paracetamol or brufen or any painkiller medicine or acidity medicine, you must ensure that you are not taking. If you are on some medicines like anti-epileptic medicines or any other medications, please consult a doctor and take a guidance. And therefore, this can help. You have to also avoid getting into a very any kind of an infection, going to crowded places and contracting infection. These things can help a long way in ensuring that there are no problems during pregnancy. Now, Neetu wants to know what is a neonatal nurse practitioner. Now, neonatal nurse practitioner is a nurse who has been trained in neonatal care. So, after your baby is born, you may require some nursing assistance to look after your baby. And these neonatal nurse practitioners can help you in doing that. They can help you for lactation assistant to look after your baby and to ensure that nothing is wrong. And these are those special people who can do that. How is care provided in the NICU? Now, NICU is a special care which is given. It's called as a neonatal intensive care unit, wherein a neonate who is unable to exist out of in a normal environment out of the mother's womb, it requires to be cared for, maybe for various reasons. Now, if it's a preemie, that is a premature baby, would require all the assistance that the mother's womb provides in an NICU, like respiratory assistance, maybe oxygen assistance, maybe thermal assistance, maintaining body temperature, ensuring that its GI tract and everything is functioning well and getting proper nutritional. If sometimes some babies may require neonatal care if they have had some birthing problems, or they were born and they had some issues, or they were growth restricted when they were born, such babies will require special care. You must be aware that even adults are put in an intensive care unit when they have complications. Likewise, babies, when they have problems, newborns, they are put in a neonatal NICU, and that is how they are cared for. What is the NICU experience? What is the question? What is the NICU experience like for parents and guardians? Actually, when your babies are in NICU, a regular counseling session is undertaken by our neonatologist for you and even your obstetrician to tell you and to talk you about your babies. So you are always told, it's sometimes a little, worrisome. Your baby is inside a chamber and you are waiting outside. But then it's always better to have a positive attitude, because you must remember that baby is being cared for in that controlled environment. Sarah wants to know how to keep physically active in the antenatal phase. As I just now mentioned, Sarah, we can go for walks daily. If you've never been doing anything, start with 2,000 steps per day. Increase to 4,000 to 5,000 steps per day. You can do it in the early mornings. You can do it in the late evenings. It's always better to have these walks twice in a day. Ensure that you're doing some light stretches. And as your pregnancy advances and you cross 32 to 34 weeks, it's a good practice to squat and have lower abdominal exercise. You can do your upper body exercise to ensure good breathing pattern. Now, Shail Shiny wants to know that she has a bicornuate uterus and should compulsory go for cervical and cerlage for continuing my pregnancy. Shail, that depends on your clinical entire history, what has been your past obstetric history, what kind of a bicornuate uterus it is, and many a times it is suggested as a preemptive or a prophylactic measure to tighten the os so that it will help in ensuring that you do not land up in a preterm delivery. Kavita wants to know that she is able to get back to my pre-pregnancy weight after my second child, though I regularly walk and keep a check on my diet. What can I do? That means, Kavita, you require to need to take a little more stretching kind of an exercise, and you may be taking a role on your diet, but I feel you must check the composition of your diet once again to ensure that you are really, really taking proper kind of diet. What should a woman know about postpartum depression? Sarah, postpartum depression is a sort of a situation. There are two phases to it. In the beginning, you have something which is called as blues. You suddenly feel that because all that apprehension of pregnancy has gone. Suddenly you are handed with a baby who seems to be absolutely helpless, not knowing what to do. And you seem to be the monitor looking after it in all its way. Suddenly you feel that you don't have enough support system. You feel that your experience is falling short. There's withdrawal of hormones in your body and you feel helpless. And this is just the blues. It's a passing phase. But sometimes there can be a serious issue. Like if you really develop a lot of melancholy, if you feel that you just can't take care of your baby, or you feel really, really remorse, then that probably is depression. And these conditions definitely require care. Now, blues can be taken off by just dissociating, having a different attitude, taking family as a support. But depression may require a therapy with a psychiatrist or a psychologist, and this has to be looked into. Is it normal to lose weight during first trimester or get severe morning sickness? Yes, Preeti, it is absolutely normal to do this. And again, vomiting during first trimester is because of sudden drop in sugars, then sudden rise in pregnancy hormones, and then maybe if you have a gastritis, it becomes overt. Again, you have to take a lot of dry foods, take some tidbits, don't overeat at one time, have a right attitude, don't go hungry for a long time. And there are various wonderful guidelines which we can give to ensure that you do not have such a weight gain. Losing 1 kg of weight during the first trimester doesn't really cause much harm to the baby. But if you go into dehydration and ketosis, that can be harmful, and this has to be taken care of. Does age matter? Yes, I just now mentioned, especially women who are beyond the age of 35 when they get pregnant can have problems like congenital abnormalities, obesity, diabetes. And even girls who are very young, younger age than less than 20 can have complications like anemia, hypertension or birthing problems. Ritu wants to know importance of folic acid in pregnancy. Ritu, if folic acid is deficient, then two, three things happen. One, the neural tube of the baby, which is the baseline foundation of the formation of the entire brain and the spinal cord, what we call as the nervous system of the baby, is forming. And if it forms in the absence of folic acid or deficiency of folic acid, then there can be congenital abnormalities in the baby, like the cranium is not developed, or there can be some brain tumors in the baby. And then these babies are not compatible with life and you may have to terminate this pregnancy. Folic acid deficiency is also associated with pathologically stuck placenta. The placenta gets stuck to the mother's womb in a pathological fashion. It is also responsible for giving you complications such as fetal growth restriction, where the baby doesn't grow to its potential or the placenta doesn't form well, giving rise to pregnancy hypertension and such kind of complications. So Sonia wants to know tips on pregnancy planning, proper weight management, proper attitude, plan exercise, do vaccinations, start folic acid supplementations, take a quick check from your doctor, find out that you are completely healthy, and then go ahead and plan your pregnancy. Radhika wants to know steps to take before getting pregnant. I think the same thing applies to you, Radhika, what I spoke to Sonia. Deepika again wants to know, during the first trimester, I had severe vaginal infection and repeatedly, why so? Yes, Deepika, what happens is during pregnancy, because of the hormonal changes in your body, there is a change in the vaginal pH. So whenever there is change in the vaginal pH, your normal protective mechanisms fall short and they cannot protect you. And your normal vaginal commensals suddenly take up their heads, and therefore you start developing infections such as bacterial vaginosis, candidiasis or maybe trichomoniasis. These were probably already prevailing there, but they become overt now during pregnancy. You require to take care. The care can be personal hygiene. You have to also treat these infections repeatedly, and these have to be cared for because otherwise they can be associated with infections which can go inside the womb causing preterm deliveries. Does hypothyroidism cause complications in conceiving? Sara, yes, they can, because hypothyroidism can cause dysfunction in ovulation, so you may not conceive. Even if you conceive, there are higher chances that you may develop miscarriages, and sometimes the babies can also have thyroid disorders. Geetika wants to know, is it true that during some pregnancies the lady glows and other times her complexion looks fading? Actually, pregnancy hormones make the woman glow in any case. The happiness of having a baby and creating a new thing, I think not only does a woman glow, but when a patient who is trying to get pregnant becomes pregnant, even the doctor starts glowing. So we are all happily there for you when you become pregnant. So Deepika wants to know, doctor, what is the role of husband in these sessions? In which sessions, Deepika? You mean to say which sessions? Okay, antenatal sessions. The husband is the pivotal point because he has to be there, understanding, supporting you, being there with you all the time when you're going through these changes. And he has to be there. Even we also encourage nowadays husbands to be there at the time of birthing. And then later on also we train through various workshops and all. Husbands are also, a part of baby caring. So they are important there, and especially they are important for you because that's going to matter to you. Now, Shalshani wants to know, after cervical encerclage and delivery, is it compulsory to take cervical cancer injection? Shailj, it's compulsory to take cervical cancer vaccination anytime between the age group of 14 to 45. That is the recommendation which is done by the FOCSI, Federation of Obstetric Gynec Societies of India, for Indian women. So whatever age group, it's important that you complete your vaccination. If you've not done it already, do it. And if not, you don't want to do it, then regularly screen yourself for cancer. It has nothing to do with cervical encephalitis. Deepika Singh wants to know, do you recommend a yoga or exercise regime to avoid postpartum? Absolutely. Yoga and exercise regimen has to be your everyday practice. Like we get up in the morning, brush your teeth. You have to exercise at least for 20 to 30 minutes daily. And out of that, 10 minutes can be yoga, 5 minutes can be meditation. It will go a long way in creating a healthy woman population and consequently healthy babies in future. Ritika wants to know, the pregnancy advice always differ from our gynec and in-laws. What should we do? See, we have to understand that change is the only thing that is constant. Things are changing, times are changing, knowledge is changing, science is evolving. So these things are going to be there. Like how we decided to change from wearing saris to wearing skirts, we have to accept certain things. And you as an intelligent woman can definitely tackle your in-laws strategically. Sarah wants to know, what measures can be taken to reduce maternal and perinatal mortality among all populations? Sarah, reducing maternal and perinatal mortality, our responsibility starts from the time of planning your babies. Am I of the right age? Am I healthy? Am I not anemic or anemic? Have I any infections? Am I obese? Am I too thin? Am I having the right mental attitude? Am I healthy to have this baby? Am I going to use proper spacing methods? And whether I'm going to do proper care during my antenatal and pregnancy period? Am I going to be positive during the entire thing? Whether I'm going to have any complications? And then at the time of birthing, am I going to be cooperative enough with my doctor? And am I going to deliver in a proper center? All these things are going to matter in reducing the perinatal mortality and maternal mortality. But I would also suggest that the most important and the simple thing is anemia. Even despite we being highly educated, still 70% of Indian women are still suffering from anemia. Their 70% of our babies are still unplanned, and therefore we are still finding very, very high numbers of perinatal mortality and morbidity. In addition, we require to have a very positive attitude towards pregnancy, and we have to have the correct scientific know-how. Deepika wants to know, can we go ahead for antenatal session in second pregnancy? Of course. Nothing, things change. You may forget what happened in your first pregnancy. Every pregnancy requires a similar kind of an attention, and you never know, you would learn something different. I have severe backache after C-section. How to control the pain? Shiles wants to know. Shiles, your backache after C-section is nothing to do with your anesthesia medicine or anything. It's postural, and plus it can be associated with calcium vitamin D deficiency. And you have to go to a physiotherapist, or you can come to us. We can guide you for back strengthening exercises. Please get into those. Your backache will go like that just within a month or two. Githika wants to know, can we skip antenatal exercises during second pregnancy as we know it? Of course not. You must do. Exercising, as I said, has to be your second nature. Can an increase in AFP during pregnancy lead to abortion? It may lead to an abortion. It can be a sign of an abnormal pregnancy. It can be associated with abnormalities in the baby and sometimes fetal growth restriction. The correct timelines and the interpretation requires to be done. Is it okay to make relations after first trimester of pregnancy? Yes, it should not be actually, depending on the fact. First of all, you must ensure that you are having proper sexual hygiene practices. You must be sure that you are not getting any infections. And in addition, you must also ensure that it is not a very violent act. And of course, you must take your doctor's guidance. Can vitamin D deficiency cause any problem? Titir Sen wants to know. Yes, vitamin D deficiency is known to be associated in backaches and, you know, sort of osteopenic exaggeration during mothers. It is also known to be associated with increase of occurrence of diabetes during pregnancy in mothers. And finally, we are also considering the baby. The baby's bone formation, if it has to be optimal while the baby is still in the mother's womb, and for that it is important that the mother is consuming enough vitamin D and calcium. Now, how can a lady be happy during pregnancy? Because many times she feels like crying with no particular reason. Githika, come on. Now we are modern women of today's era, and we have to learn to have proper mind modulation. Positive mental attitude is the only solution for every issues, and therefore we have to learn to ride above it. It's always important that you can speak to a doctor, and maybe the doctor can see you and help you in getting into the right perspective. Deepika wants to know, is it true that during breastfeeding phase a lady cannot conceive? Yes. Now, it's been found that if the woman is undergoing rigorous breastfeeding, means that she breastfeeds at least 5 to 6 times in the night and in the day, in that situation, because of high levels of prolactin in the body, ovulation may not happen, but that doesn't mean, and she may not even have menstruation. But absence of menstruation doesn't essentially mean that she will not ovulate, and possibilities of pregnancy are still there. And this particular method of contraception or birth control is called as the natural method, where lactational amenorrhea is known to reduce the possibility of conception. But for that, your breastfeeding has to be more frequent. Ritika, how will I be updated on my infant status when I am not in the NICU? Can I breastfeed my preterm infant? Of course, your neonatology specialist is going to guide you. Sometimes they will ask you to give your breast milk through a pump and then feed the baby. Or sometimes they may, if the baby's suckling reflex is good enough, they may advise you to take the breastfeeding where you can directly feed your baby. What kind of questions to ask a neonatologist? You can ask the neonatologist whether my baby's weight is growing well, whether the baby's cry is normal, is my baby having any infection, is the baby ready to take breastfeeds, and how is the general condition. These are the simple questions, and many a times, even if you don't ask questions, your neonatologist is going to give answers to many of them. Because when the baby is, especially in the NICU, it happens to be our responsibility that we look after the baby as if you are looking at your baby. Navya wants to know, hello madam, 8 months after delivery I have back pain. Did MRI have SI joint dysfunction? Can it be cured? Yes, you need to require to take an advice with an orthopedic surgeon, and there are a lot of physiotherapy measures which can help you in overcoming such kind of sacroiliac joint dysfunction, and it is overcome by exercising and physiotherapy. So just don't worry, Navya, and ensure that you are taking proper postural changes and you are taking proper calcium and vitamin D vitamin D supplementations. Sonia wants to know that women having heavy menstruation flow for 45 days post delivery, is this normal? Actually, 45 days post delivery, if there is a menstrual flow, you require to see your doctor. Normally after delivery, a woman has bleeding for the first 4 to 5 days, which gradually reduces in number, and then over a period of time she becomes amenorrheic. Many times the first period will resume after maybe 1 month, 6 weeks or 6 months, depending on how she's breastfeeding. So if a woman is bleeding for 45 days post-delivery, she requires to go to the doctor and ensure that there is no problem. Gitika wants to know, is it true that during pregnancy, what books we read or movies we watch has an impact on the baby? Yes, that's called as garbha sanskar. Your mental attitude, your way of thinking helps. There are so many studies now globally which have shown that if you communicate with your baby, that is making the baby's psychological fear-free potential starts developing in utero. Your attitude, your thinking, so simple things like how we think, how we react, how we respond are going to cause certain chemical changes in our body, a lot of anxiety that's going to cause trouble. And if you try to alleviate these things, that definitely is going to ensure that your baby is going to be healthy. Malti wants to know, hi, my servant is having cervix problem, so having difficulty in getting pregnant. Is there any, of course there's solution. She may be having cervicitis, or she may be having a short cervix, or she can be having issues, maybe it's a torn cervix. All this can be taken care of. There can be some medications, there can be some surgical corrections, or there can be some simple things like cauterization which can help your servant conceiving. So now, thank you very much for being with us this afternoon. I hope I have been able to answer all your questions. It has been wonderful being with you. And I must tell you that we really, really enjoy a lot of questions when they come, because then that tells us that yes, it's so wonderful to know that our patients think before they get into embark into such a responsible role as becoming a mother and bringing up their children. Wish you happy mothering and happy childbearing. Love you all. Thank you so much.